You know, people think about, you know, greenhouse gases, they think about climate change, they think about weather-related events, things like that. Doctors, the public health community looks at it from a public health standpoint. You're talking about this, these particulates. Air pollution is essentially these small little particulates. You can't see them. They're about 1/30th the size of a hair, and they're out there in the air you breathe. And we know better now in terms of what that does to the body, the sort of impact that it can have on the body, particularly to people who have underlying illness, specifically heart and lung disease. They're the people who are going to most be adversely impacted by this. Non-fatal heart attacks as well, irregular heartbeats. These are the types of things that are of concern when you have more pollution. And let me just tell you the numbers here a little bit in terms of the numbers of people likely affected. 1,500 to 3,600 premature deaths annually. That would have, decreasing those deaths or preventing those deaths, that would have been a benefit of the Clean Power Plan. 90,000 asthma attacks, 1,700 heart attacks. You can read the numbers, but there is a direct health benefit to reducing air pollution. I almost can't believe I'm saying that, but there is. And people, I think, generally know it. These are some of the specifics that you should have in your back pocket as well.